Did you know that you could take data without using the Simcenter Testlab software and not using a PC? So really all you need is tablet application for the SCADAS XS. You would use Testlab Scope, Android tablet, and your hardware. The SCADAS XS can be used in these three different modes to collect data. So you can use it as a standalone operating system. You can also use the XS like any other front end where I plug it in using an Ethernet cable to a PC, and I can use Simcenter Testlab to collect data and process it online. And then the third way of using the SCADAS XS is with the Android tablet. So this is the Scope app. I'm gonna open that up. And that connects to my SCADAS XS. When I'm using the SCADAS XS, I do not need to go into Testlab to create a new test template. I can do that right here from the home screen. This is a list of my existing templates that I have on this particular piece of hardware. But if I want to make a new test, I can just click New. I have every channel available to me here that would be on my XS. So my 12 inputs, my headset input, my digital here as well for another binaural head. I can also set up my tacos, my GPS channels. I can do CAN. And then I have my measurement settings, and here's my video. If we turn on the front camera, you'll get to see me smiling and waving. So I can set up the front or rear camera. And the idea for that is to give you some synchronized video to your data, which is a nice thing. So you could potentially point the rear camera at whatever you're testing. If it's an in-vehicle test, and maybe you want to view the road surface as you drive over it, turn on the cameras, both front and rear, so you could monitor what the driver is doing as well as the track they're driving over. So that's maybe some good uses for that video capability, which is really nice. Again, measurement, I have everything available to me here where I can do multiple sample rates based on channel groups. So you can see my vibration, static, and other channel groups. I can set all that up. I can do triggers as well as the duration and everything I need to do. I'm just going to go into a basic headset test that we have here. So I'll click measure. And you can see I've got the headset plugged in. It's showing me the levels as those come in. And I can view this in different ways. You can also see a digital display, and I can look at any channels that I want to here. I could populate this with as many as I want, as well as going in here and changing that channel selection and the layout. Kind of the base view here allows me to hit a big record button if I want. And if I go here under functions, I can look at a live FFT. I can change that as well by clicking on this function selection. So maybe I want to look at octaves or even specific or total loudness. So we can even do some sound quality stuff right here using the Scope app. Okay. I can also look at things with a color map. If I click this 3D, I'm now looking at a 3D color map with the three different axes being amplitude in terms of color, my unit, bark, and then time. Okay, so this is updating based on time. We can also set that up to track on RPM if we were to set up a rotating machinery test using the XS and Scope. We can look at things based on RPM. Okay, so I'll go back to 2D. And maybe show the ability to go to some of that as well. So I could do time as a strip chart. I just really like this function selector because I can look at everything here. It's one of my favorites. Once I have the data, I can come here under runs, and you can see under headset, I've got two runs. I've also got some runs under this other test for impact measurements. If I go into a given run, let's say I want to do some analysis on an existing run, you can see my hammer and Excel test data. So if I want to just get that kind of frequency response, I'll do a selection. So this is my hammer. If we look at the Excel, I can see a peak, and I can go here and select other hits as well to get some different data. So there's a lot I can do here. If I go back to one of the headset recordings, I could do some playback. So if I have the headset plugged in, it'll play back, and it's actually an equalized playback because it's coming through the SCADAS XS hardware. I can hit start and listen to any channel. It doesn't have to be the headset. I could listen to an Excel or anything that I've collected data on. And I can even do some filtering, as you can see here. So if I wanted to do some playback with filtering, I could do that. So there's high pass, low pass. There's all kinds of good filters that I can use for playback. If I go back to an existing run here under runs, and let's look at this one maybe. Statistics. So this is here. Now I can go and select maybe some different duration and look at the statistics over that. Some things we're showing too is I can add run comments. So if I want to make a comment on a run, either immediately following the acquisition or now, as you're seeing, I can do that. I can also change the name of the run. So when I'm in a data collection, if I go back to templates. So if I come in here into measure, I can come in here and I can change the run name. So instead of it being the template name with an automatic increment, I could come in here and change that and say webinar run one. And then when I save that, now this is webinar run one. You can even share some of these templates. So let's say I make a template and Charles likes it so much he doesn't want to go out there and make it himself. I can go here to manage where I can delete these templates, or I can select one and I can export it or save it to a different location. I can even bring in things from an SD card. So if I have templates that are within my organization but not imported into the SCADAS XS hardware, I can bring them in from the micro SD card that is in the unit itself. Now, none of the data that I collect using the Scope app is saved to the tablet at all. The raw data is saved to this micro SD card that is within the unit itself. And I can bring that micro SD card out, put it in the PC for more advanced processing in Testlab at any time. The other thing to mention when it comes to the process data, so if I come in here and we'll go look at another run again, look at one of these headset runs. If I process a channel, this is kind of a meaningless spectral plot just on noise. But if I wanted to save this, and I click on this, I can export and I can send that to Excel, which I could read directly into Testlab. I can save it as a reference curve for future data collection on my XS if this is a repeatable test, or I can export the sound to a WAV file. Okay. I can also just screenshot the tablet and have a picture of this process data. But whatever I process on the tablet here, it's not saved unless I explicitly export it to Excel or something like that. The data is being processed using the app over a Wi-Fi connection between the unit and the tablet itself. Did you know that this little menu here, these three lines, I can get some information about my system as well? So if I click on XS info, it'll tell me the battery life of my XS. Here's the battery life of my tablet. Here's the battery life of my XS. It shows me how much is left on my SD card, what the firmware is on the XS I'm using. And I can come in here under settings and you can set this up to on the main page. You can jump right into a scope mode based on the last template you used instead of coming to that home screen that I came to. And then you can also set it up to just jump into recording if you want, as well as your automatic decimal points, all that other stuff. Everything can be customized here in this app, which is really nice. There's a lot of customization that's available to you. So now that we've given a quick overview of the Scope app, I figured we could highlight some main points.